And a good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to acknowledge, of course, all the board members and the acting CEO, and most importantly, all the staff of Food Processors Limited. It gives me much pleasure to be here. As you know, I did not expect such a formal gathering. I thought I'll come and meet all the staff and see the truck, and then we'll have some chats. But I'd like to take this opportunity, obviously, to say that, as highlighted earlier on, that Food Processors, obviously, in respect of its sales, is doing well. It obviously has shown there is a demand for the products that Food Processors actually makes. The reality is that of COVID-19, a lot of the countries actually have, as I mentioned yesterday, I was at the agricultural show, it's brought home a few home truths. People now, of course, are planting more. People are now more understanding of the fact that we don't necessarily have to be reliant on overseas countries for your source of food. But of course, other countries may also depend on us. And as we've seen in the past couple of months, even with the borders being closed and whilst the freight was taken across borders, Fiji Airways flights saw about 80 to 85% of all the freight was to do with food and Yangona, etc., to do with agricultural produce. Food Processors obviously has been through a number of different, I suppose, processes itself, has gone through a period itself in terms of where there were, at one point in time, it was not doing as well, the machinery was out of date. There's obviously, we saw an opportunity to be able to invest in food processes. We have, of course, provided the truck and various other machineries in the past, we provided loans in the past. And we decided that we need to ensure that the balance sheet of Food Processors needs to be strong. And this is one of the reasons why we converted the debt into equity. Therefore, you have less debts in your books now. Hopefully we'll be doing a settlement of the other debt that you've got. So Food Processors can stand on its own 2 feet. Pacific Crown, of course, is a very good brand. It's recognized not just in Fiji, but in USA. If you go to USA, in particular in California, people are eating, these produce that you make over here. But we have to be able to ensure that in order for a food processing plant to do well, there has to be consistency in the supply of your raw material. So, for example, you can Doruka during the Doruka season, and that's only for a few months. In Fiji, we don't necessarily have plantation of Doruka. A lot of it grows in the wild. In the same way, when we talk about breadfruit, we don't have breadfruit orchards, which grows and people just go and pick it up. We don't actually have a farm that grows, breadfruit, or Evie for that matter. People break it, it's in the wild, and they sell it by the roadside, but we can this produce. Things like jackfruit, all of these produces are there, but we don't actually have actual plantations of them. That will give you consistency in supply, it'll give you better pricing, it'll be able to give you better supply to this factory, and then of course you'll have a much better production output. So I would like to of course thank the board and the management and of course the staff for the strides, the new strides that Food Processors has made. Even during this period we have not seen any unemployment take place with Food Processors. I would like to encourage the board and the management to look at the new incentive that government has provided. Under the new job scheme, we are saying that if a company hires more new people, we will actually pay the minimum wage rate, $2.68 an hour. So if the company goes and hires new people for the next 3 months, we'll pay the $2.68. If there's any additional amount to be paid, then the company pays that and pays the FNPF. So I'd like to urge the company to take advantage of this particular program or initiative the government has put in place. I'd like to round off to thank all the staff for your perseverance, for your hard work, your commitment to this company. I know a number of you have been working here for quite a number of years. We'd like to thank you for that. Please understand that we want to ensure that the company does do well. If necessary, develop partnerships with other organizations. And as we've discussed with the chairman, that organizations like AMA and Food Processors can work a lot more closely together because there's a lot of synergy that can be developed between those two organizations. Yesterday I was at Navuso Agricultural Technical College, where we had something like about, I think, 10 students who have graduated from that institute. And government has partially funded the ability of these people to get individual land leases themselves. So they don't just get trained at the technical college, the agricultural college, but they're able to now get, in this particular instance, they got a 50-year lease. So, and it's been paid for. So they know that you know, they've got proper title, they can go to FDB, get a loan, develop their farms, and be able to become a supplier, for example, to this organization. So when we talk about any company and we talk about the agricultural sector within the any company within the agricultural sector, we have to look at the entire the chain process, you know, supply chain process. At the moment in Fiji, there's a lot of farmers who are quite old. A lot of young people don't want to become farmers. You know, farming is not necessarily seen as something that you do, you know, if you're doing well. So essentially, we want to encourage more people to go to the farms, become proper farmers, supply to the chain that brings up food to this particular factory. You can it, you process it, and of course we value add it, and then we can of course export it, but also for domestic consumption. So I'd like to thank everybody that's been involved. It's we wish we can give you more trucks, but at this point in time we've given you one truck, and you know, Isoa, who heads our budget division, he's the Mamangi guy, so you know, we have to work together with him to ensure that we're able to look after everybody that deserves the attention that's required. So Vinaka Vakalevu, for your not just for your attention, but also for your commitment to this organization. Vinaka, thank you.